more lateral one is called the putamen. Okay, in between the lentiform cells and the thalamus, the internal capsule is present. This is the internal capsule. The internal capsule is present here. Okay, this is an internal capsule. If this is an internal capsule, there must be external capsule also. Here is an external capsule. This is an external capsule. On both sides, the external capsule are present. This is an external capsule. This is an third ventricle. These two are the thalamus. This is an internal capsule. This is an lentiform cells which is having a globus pallidus, putamen, and this is an external capsule. Okay. And more lateral to the external capsule, there is mass of gray matter is present. This mass of gray matter, which is present more lateral to the external capsule, this mass of the gray matter is called as an claustrum. This is nothing but the claustrum. This is the claustrum, which is present more lateral to the external capsule. Okay, and this is the mass of the gray matter. And more lateral to the claustrum, there is an extreme capsule is present. There is a white matter is present here, which is present more lateral to the claustrum. This portion is called extreme capsule. This is an extreme capsule, which is present more lateral to the claustrum. Okay, and there is one more nuclei, which is C-shape. The C-shape nuclei, which is joining this lentiform cell and the thalamus together, this C-shape nuclei is present here. Okay, the C-shaped nuclei, which is joining the thalamus and the lentiform cell together, this C-shaped nuclei is called as a caudate nuclei. This is the caudate nuclei. And at the tail of this caudate nuclei, there is mass of gray matter. Large mass of gray matter is present here. This large mass of gray matter is called as an amygdala. Okay, this is actually what we called as an basal ganglia, or now it has been called as an basal nuclei. So this is the third ventricle. This is the third ventricle. Okay, these two are the thalamus. Thalamus. This is an internal capsule. Internal capsule, which is present in between the thalamus and the lentiform cell. This is the lentiform cell, which is having more medially the globus pallidus and laterally putamen. This portion of the lentiform cell is called as globus pallidus. Globus pallidus. And this portion is called as a putamen. This portion is called as putamen. And more laterally to the lentiform cell, this portion is the external capsule. external capsule, and this is the claustrum. More laterally to the external capsule, this portion of the mass of the gray matter is called claustrum, and this is the extreme capsule. Okay, this is an extreme capsule, and if I clearly draw the caudate nucleus here, if this is the thalamus, this portion is the thalamus, and this is the lentiform cell. The lentiform cell is having more medially the globus pallidus, and this is the putamen here. This portion, the C-shaped nuclei is present here, which is joining the caudate, which is joining the lentiform cell to the thalamus. This nuclei is having a tail, and at the tail, the large mass of the gray matter is present here. This nuclei is called as an caudate nuclei. This is called caudate nuclei. And at the tail of the caudate nuclei, this portion is called amygdala. So that's all for the structural part of the basal ganglia or the basal nuclei. We'll be continuing about the basal nuclei in the next part. So do like, share and subscribe my channel, and press bell icon for more notification. Thank you. Like, share and subscribe my channel to reboot your knowledge, and press bell icon for all notifications.